Good morning, students. Hope you are all fine. So today we are going to discuss about some silly questions and some silly mistakes. Because as you all know that I ask that all students that you have to send me pics of practical number 6. So many of the students send me that pics of practical number 6. In those pics, so many students have did so many silly mistakes. Which kind of silly mistake? Let's see. Suppose this is our readings. This is our 4 readings divided by 4. And the answer was, you can't believe that. This is the answer. Many of the students did the same mistake. Not only one. Many of the students make the same mistake. They don't know how to take average. 4 readings divided by 4, that means your answer will be in 10 to 11. So, dear students, dear friends, you have to take average. 4 readings divided by 4, the answer will be in this digit. Clear? Now go ahead. That many of the students told me that they don't know how to take average. That means they all know how to take average, but how to write in observation table, that they don't know. Suppose this is our observation table. View rate reading. Initial reading. Final reading. And last one is difference. Final reading. First reading our second reading, our third reading, last one is our fourth reading, and concordant reading. So suppose our final reading is between 10 to 11. So here we will write 10.7, 10.7, 10.2, 10.3. Why? The same. Because suppose this is our view rate. So, in first reading, we will do set 0. Here our the funnel. Here, we will do the set 0. This first reading, we will take. Then after for second reading, why we here write 10.7? Because after first reading, we already did the set 0. So we are going to again set 0. If 10.7, our solution will be here. Our solution will be here for 10.7. After the first reading, our solution is here. Then we will do the again set 0. Again set 0. Then we will again do the titration. Then again 10.7. Our second reading will be here. That means solution comes here. That's why second reading is 10.7. Then after for third reading. For third reading, our 10.7 is here. Then after for third reading, again we will do the set 0. Then 10.2. 10.2 above. 10.2, then we will write here 10.2. Then after 10.2, our solution will be here. Then again we will do set 0. Then our solution is here. Now we will take number 4 reading. Fourth one reading is 10.3. Then 10.3. So whenever, every time we will do the set 0, every time we are doing, what we are doing? Every time we are doing set 0. That's why we will write here 0, 0, 0. Now, understood, dear students? Then difference you already know. 10.7 minus 0. 10.7. 10.7. 10.2. And 10.3. So, here you have to take 4 reading and divide it by 4. This is our 4 reading. 10.7 plus 10.7 plus 10.2 plus 10.3. We have 4 readings, that's why we have to write divided by 4. Our reading is between 10. 10.7, 10.7, 10.2, our answer will be 10.2 or 10.3, whatever. So remember, if our reading is 10 point something, answer will be also 10 or 11. Okay students, now clear is this? So dear students, I am repeating again. See, pilot reading is between 10 to 11 and our first reading. When we are taking first reading, we have already done the period set 0. Okay, till here complete. First reading, after, before first reading, we did already the set 0. Then after, what is the first reading? This is our period. Okay, funnel 0. We have already done the set 0. Then we will take the 10 first reading. What is our first reading? 10.7. Here 10.7. Already clean, clear. So after first reading, what we are doing? Again we will do the set 0. After first reading, what we are doing, we will do again set 0. That's why we have to write set 0. Clear? Then for second reading, what we will do, set 0. Then again we will titrate. Then after titrate, we have already 10.7. Then our solution is, will be here for second reading. So clear? We have now second reading. But after second reading, again we will do the set 0. After second reading, we will do the set 0. That's why we have to write 0, 0. Then we will do the third reading. For third reading, our solution is here. Now we will do the titration. Then after titration, we have 10.2. So here our 10.2. So third reading complete. But after third reading, again, what we will do? Again, set 0. That's why we have to write again 0, 0. So, our solution is here. Now, we will do the fourth reading. We will do, whatever. Then, we are going to take the fourth reading. For fourth reading, 10.3 is here. 10.3 is here. So, now we have 4 reading. So, you now understood why we are right here 0, 0, 0. Then, final reading is 0, then 10. Difference is initial reading minus final reading. How to take the difference? Initial reading minus final reading. So, 10.7 minus 0, 10.7, 10.7 minus 0, 10.7, the same reading we will get. Then after we have to take average. Dear friends, don't forget how to calculate the average. This is so silly mistakes. So remember how to calculate the average. Okay, students? This is about the first method, how to take readings and how to write in the observation table. Now we will discuss about the second method. How to write and how to take the second method? Here we have the same pilot reading will be 10 to 11. First reading is 10.7. Suppose this is our due rate funnel. Here we have 0. For first reading, before first reading, you already know that we are going to set 0. In first reading, this is the same. In any method, we have to write near 0, 0. Because before first reading, remember, before first reading, we are going to set 0. So here, in any method, first reading, in below, final reading, always 0, 0. Now, 10.7 solution will be here. This is our first reading. Okay, first reading 10.7. Now, after first reading, but before second reading, we will continue here. Continue. Not we are going to set 0. We will continue from 10.7. We will continue from 10.7. That's why we have to write 10.7. Now understood? In first method, every time we are going to do set 0. That's why we have to write 0. But we are going to continue from the first reading. Before second reading, we will continue from the first reading. We are not going to set 0. That's why we have to write 10.7. 10.7. Now we will take the second reading. For second reading, we have 20.1. So we will write here 20.1. So again, we are not going to again set 0, but we will continue. We will continue from the 10.7. We will continue for second reading. We will continue from the second reading, 20.1. Now, we will take the third reading. After third reading, so our third reading is 30.0. Clear? Then after third reading, we will continue from the third reading. So, here we have to write 30. Third reading, 30. Now, we will take the reading, another 40. Our fourth reading is 40. So, now understood, dear students? After this, 10.7 minus 0, 10.0. Initial reading minus final reading. So, answer will be, suppose, 10.0. here 10. So difference 20 minus 10, 30 minus 20, 40 minus 30. You have to take average for this 4 reading. This is our V2. Don't forget 10.7 plus 10.5 plus 10.2 plus 10 divided by 4. So now you understood. I hope that all the students understood this second method. That is, what is the difference in first method and second method? In first method, every 10 we are going to set 0. In second method, we will set 0 only for one time. Okay, students? Let's continue. Another mistake. In acid, what is the molecular mass? For HCl, 36.5. Many of the students written 40, 46, 46.1. So dear students, for HCl, molecular mass is 36.5, HNO3, 63.0, H2SO4, 98.0, oxalic acid, .2H2O, H2C2O4, .2H2O, that is hydrous. With water, hydrous. Without water, anhydrous. So H2SO4, .2H2O, 126 molecular mass. Without water, it's 90. In acid, these are molecular mass for base and NaOH. NaOH is 40, KOH 56, Na2CO3 106, Na2CO3.10H2O. Only Na2CO3 without water, anhydrous. With water, hydrous, 286, K2CO3 138, NaHCO3 84. Dear friends, you have to remember, in our titration practical, we have to find out in any stream if that is acid or base. If you have to find oxalic acid stream, then you have to write the molarity of oxalic acid. If in A, if you have to find K2CO3 base, if you have to find base molarity, that means you have to find the strength of base, then you have to write molecular mass of base. See, in A, suppose acid has given 0.1 molarity. Acid has given 0.1 molarity, and you have to find base Na2CO3 for strength. So from A, you have to find molarity of base. So every time, whatever you have to find, acid or base strength, that acid or base strength, you have to write molarity of molecular mass. Suppose you have given base molarity, that means you have Na2CO3 0.1 molarity of Na2CO3, and you have to find the molarity of, that is, strength of acid HNO3. Then you have to write the molarity of HNO3. Whatever you have to find, acid or base, whatever you have to find strength of acid or base, that only acid or base you have to write the molarity, that means molecular mass. Still not understand what I am saying? Suppose 0.1 molar you have HNO3, and you have to find the strength of HNO3 NaOH. So in this A, you have 0.1 molar HNO3 and strength of NaOH. So in that equation, molarity into molecular mass, the you have to write mass molarity of NaOH. Clear? This is the first example. Now second. strength of HCl. You have to find the strength of HCl. Now that equation, second calculation, molarity into molecular mass. So you have to write compulsory molecular mass of HCl. See, whatever you have to find acetone base strength. Find acetone base strength. Whatever you have to find acetone base strength, you have to write the same molarity of molecular mass. Here we have molar mass 0.1 molar HNO3N. Find out the strength of NaOH. In the strength of NaOH calculation, molar into molecular mass. Here we have to compulsory write molecular mass of NaOH. Same in this equation, molar into molecular mass. So we have to write compulsory molecular mass of HCl. Whatever you have to find acetone base strength, that only molecular mass you have to write. Clear students? Dear students, another thing I came to know that many of the students didn't write what I wrote on the board. Suppose this is your notebook. Suppose your ruler. Okay. Now write aim. Here apparatus. Solutions. The same line. Burette. Same pipette or flask, whatever you have, you can write. Indicator and color change. Then equation. No need to write procedure. Clear? Why I am forcing to write this? In board, we have to write the same format. If you write the same format, you will get full marks. So I clearly want to say that you have to write in the same format. Aim, apparatus, solutions, equation. In solutions, burette, pipette, indicator and color change. Then equation and then calculation. And last, result. So in the same format, you have to write all titrations, practicals, because in 12th, you have to do the same titration, but solution will be different. So try to practice the same format you have to write. Okay students? In last, I want to speak some name of the students who have sent me their pics. I have written their names. First, I want to speak some names. Divya, Rohit, Pachaunki, Anshna, Archana, Sirsa Roshni, Jhashweta, Neil, Kumawat Roshni, Govind, Kritika, Tanya, Shubham, Nimisha, Iram Balu, Neha, Manasvi, Shreya, Hina, Shweta Mishra, Vikas, Harsh, Gayatri, Manali, Reena. In another, yes, Alok, Chandrashekhar, Pushkar, Gajendra, Sanket, Man, Rohan, Kartik, Mirika, Krishna, and last one, Mitesh. Clap for the students. These all students already sent me the pics of practical number 6. And not only practical number 6, they all sent me 1 to 6 practical number 6 and written and sent me their pics. I asked for only practical number 6, but they all sent me 1 to 6. So, clap for the students has already sent me their pics. So, congratulations to all the students. Now, hope another students will write these all practicals and send me pics of these all practicals. And whatever you have, if you have any query, any doubts, inform me or you can message me or you can call me. Till then, stay safe, stay home, and goodbye, dear students.